Hi, Kerry here from My Cloud Bookkeeping. Some time back, I created some videos to show you how foreign currency transactions work in QuickBooks Online. And since then, QuickBooks looks different, and there have been some really great improvements in how currency transactions are matched and recorded. I thought it might be a good time to redo the videos. Now, if you're not familiar with QuickBooks Online, you might just be tempted to enter everything at a one-for-one exchange rate, thinking that you can recalculate and clear it up at year end, or your accountant can clear it up for you, but there's no need to do this. Multi-currency in QuickBooks Online works seamlessly if you just know how to use it. So let's set it up and walk through a transaction.
Here we are in the sample company, and if you want to turn currency on, you pop up here to the gear icon on the right, and we go to Account and Settings. Multi-currency will show up under Advanced. And we scroll down and here's currency. Now, as you can see, this is already turned on. If it wasn't, there would be a pencil icon on the right and you would turn it on. Now, a big scary warning is going to come up to say that you can't turn it off. And I don't understand why there's that big scary warning, because turning on currencies isn't that big a deal, except that some of your reports are going to have some annoying columns out to the right with different currency variations on them that you can very easily exclude. Actually wish they wouldn't have them there, but you can go ahead, turn on currency, and this is where you select your home currency. I'm using a Canadian sample company and the home currency is Canadian dollars. There might be circumstances when you want to have a home currency that's different to the country that you're in. Some people will be using, for example, US dollars if they've got multiple entities, or maybe a euro. So this is where you choose the currency that you want most of your transactions and your reports to be in. Typically, it's going to be the same country that you're in. What I'm going to do now is set up a new vendor or a supplier, whichever version your QuickBooks says, and we're going to make sure it's in the currency we're going to be doing the transactions in. As I mentioned, home currency Canadian, so I need to choose which currency this particular vendor is. And now this is a warning that is important. Once you've created the supplier, you cannot change the currency. So do make sure that you get this correct the first time, otherwise you have to back stuff out, make it inactive. It's a bit of a mess. Not insurmountable, but a mess. Yes, we want our supplier to be in US dollars. So what name will we give to this supplier? Not feeling terribly imaginative today. I'm gonna go with new supplier and click save. So now I'm going to enter a bill. I'm going to say new bill from new supplier in US dollars. I'm just going to pop it back to last month. It just makes it a little easier for running the reports. For the category, let's get some computer and internet expenses for 10,000 US dollars. I'll actually make it 1,000. I'm going to ignore sales tax for the sake of this exercise. Normally you will have sales tax. And we're not going to make it billable or anything else. We're simply going to buy some computer and internet expenses for 1,000 US dollars. The rate that's come up here is the rate that QuickBooks is pulling for this day. Just to make it a little easier for our example, I'm going to go with 1.25. I just want it to be for this transaction only, so you can see exactly what's happening. And then we click save and close. What I'm going to do now is run a profit and loss report so that you can see the transaction that's come through last month. If we have a look here, we have computer and internet expenses of 1,250. So let's click through, see what's in here. The only thing in here is our purchase from the new supplier. And you see that it shows up as 1,000 US dollars with the exchange rate of 1.25. creating an expense of 1,250. So we can see that that has worked beautifully. So now we're going to go and pay that supplier. So we're going to go new, pay bills, and we have to change the currency to be US dollars. And we're going to pay our new supplier today. I'm going to say that today the exchange rate is 1.3. Keep in mind that the rate that QuickBooks pulls up is totally fine. If you want to go and look elsewhere to search out different rates, you can. I haven't had any problems with using the QuickBooks rates. I'm only changing it so that we can, in this exercise, have some easy numbers to work with. So we're going to have an exchange rate of 1.3. We're paying this on the 7th of June, and I'm going to click save and close. So now let's have a look at our income statement. It goes right through until June 7, which is today. So I'm going to run this report again, just refresh it. and we still have the computer and internet expenses of $1,250, even though when we paid, it was $1,300. So let's scroll down here. We have an exchange gain or loss of $50. And this is the difference between the 1.25 exchange rate when we purchased the items and the 1.3 when we paid for it. So you can see that QuickBooks has very easily been able to calculate an exchange gain or loss based on the changes in exchange rates from the date that you purchased to the date that you paid. Now, another thing you might be thinking is, how do I set up an accounts payable or an accounts receivable account in a different currency? Let's just go and have a look and see what happened for our balance sheet at May 31st, which was when we had that unpaid bill. So I'm going to switch it back here to last month. I'm going to run our report. Now, if we scroll down here, we can see that we have accounts payable US dollars for $1,250. We didn't create this account. QuickBooks did it automatically when we created the US dollar vendor and posted a transaction into it. So this is not anything you have to be concerned about. But out of interest, let's have a quick look and see what shows up when we run an accounts payable report. So I'm just going to pop into a new tab. And grab an accounts payable aging summary. We want to change it back to last month and run the report. And do we see here? It's showing up in Canadian dollars. Actually, on the balance sheet as well, it was showing up in Canadian dollars. If we want to see what we owe that vendor in US dollars, which is the currency that the expense was in, we need to go and have a look at the actual vendor. So if we go here and we have a look at new supplier, we can see we owe them $1,000. So it can get a little bit confusing when you're looking at your reports, because anytime you're running a report that includes a mix of Canadian and US or any other currencies, it's going to be shown in the home currency. So you want to have a look at the actual source transaction or the vendor to see the amount in their currency. I hope that's not too confusing.
If you are selling in other currencies, it works exactly the same way. You set up a currency, in the currency you'll be charging them, send the invoice, and record the payment. So I hope that helps you to understand how currency transactions show up in QuickBooks Online. Reach out if you have any questions. And if this video was useful, click like below, subscribe to my channel. If there's anything else you'd like to know about, please let me know, because my next video could be for you. Cheers.